There's a section inside of the Gospels where we read about the night that Judas had betrayed Jesus as he arrived with a multitude of people to have him arrested. The scriptures tell us whom the multitude was that accompanied Judas, and it says that they were chief priests, captains of the temple, and elders of the Jewish faith. Their mission was to take hold of Jesus and to bring him to stand before the high priest Caiaphas to determine his fate for proclaiming that he was the Son of God. As the multitude attempted to take hold of Jesus, we read how Peter had took out his sword and with one swoop had struck someone in the crowd, immediately cutting off his ear. We learn in scripture that this person whom Peter had struck was a servant of the high priest by the name of Malchus. Immediately after this had taken place, Jesus tells Peter to put down his sword, and as Jesus kneels down, he touches the side of the man's head and immediately restores his ear. Now, I'm sure we've heard this story 1,000 times, but the meaning behind it is far more deeper than just simply telling us that violence is not the way. If we look at what Peter did and to whom he did it to, we can start to see the deeper meaning of what took place that night. As mentioned earlier, the man whom Peter struck was a servant of the high priest, and the act of striking him down with that sword would have been considered a crime that would have been punishable by death had Peter been convicted. But let's take a look at what Jesus did. He knelt down and immediately had healed the man. Not just a covering up of the wound to stop the bleeding, but he had completely restored the man's ear back, without a scratch to be seen. So in a court of law, there would be zero evidence to convict Peter of this capital crime. Now looking back at this scene, I hope you can start to see how this incident was foreshadowing exactly what Jesus Christ has done for each and every one of us in our lives. When Jesus took on the cross and willingly died, he bore the sins of the world and had covered them up with his shed blood. The same way he willingly covered up Peter's offense to save him, he has done for you and I. So when we stand before God, the evidence has been washed away that could have convicted us as sinners. The same way Jesus saved Peter from being put to death for his capital crime that night, we too have been saved from our sins. We who were once sinners have now been restored. And there is now zero evidence that we are anything other than perfected when we are in Christ. The scriptures speak of Jesus as the one who has loved us and washed us from our sins in his own blood. I pray that we all will have a passion to take the good news of the gospel message and share it with this lost world. Thank you so much for listening.